In this video, I'm going to talk about the different ways of adding closed captions to your YouTube videos, and I'm going to show you an awesome service that I use for my captions. Let's go. Hi, my name is Dan. On this channel, I help busy people with creative side hustles find motivation and the right tools to simplify their creative process. So if that's you, I would love for you to subscribe. But either way, I encourage you to keep going, keep creating, even if you're doing it at a slower pace. This past week in Sydney was incredible. It was so beautiful. The weather is just perfect at the moment. I got up one morning to go to the beach for sunrise at 5:30 and I got a pretty good photo, pretty happy with that. And I did a little behind the scenes vlog on my IGTV. It's on my photography Instagram account if you want to check that out. But I digress. So hit the like button and let's jump in. Okay, why are captions important? Using captions ensures accessibility for deaf people and people with hearing impairment. It's also really helpful for people whose first language isn't English. I can speak from experience as a German living in Australia. Years ago, when I started watching English-speaking content, I would always turn on the subtitles to easily follow along. I even still do this sometimes in case I'm struggling to understand the accent or if there's too much noise or sound effects going on and I can't hear what people are saying. I actually would have needed that for Tenet. I went to the cinema to watch it and it was so loud and I literally didn't understand a word. It was saying, can't tell you what it was about. Would have loved some captions there. Let me know in the comments below if you ever sat through an entire movie not knowing what it was about. Anyway, it's not only nice to offer captions on your videos, but it ultimately also opens up the opportunity to reach a larger audience. There are really three different ways of adding captions to your videos. Number one is the YouTube automatic captions. Now, this is the truly lazy way of doing it and only works if you don't care about the results, because these captions are computer generated and are often wrong, especially if you're not pronouncing the words a certain way. English second language, once again, just saying. Number two, creating captions in your editing software. This is what I used to do for my first few videos. I would write the captions in Premiere Pro and line it all up myself. Depending on the length of your video, this can be a quite long and tedious task. And as creators who only have time to work on their projects after work and on weekends, we don't want to be spending our time on tasks like this. And number three, outsourcing the caption writing. This is what I do now. And just to be clear right from the start, this is not free. But if your videos are the average YouTube length of about 10 minutes, you shouldn't be out of pocket much here. And I'll tell you what I pay in a minute. By outsourcing, I mean having someone else write the captions for you. This can be through freelancing sites such as Fiverr or, and this is what I do, using an online captioning service such as ref.com. Now, the benefit of the latter is that there will always be someone available to do your captions. And the ordering and uploading process is really simple and the same every time. I've never used Fiverr for captioning, but I can imagine that it's probably frustrating to set up a process with a new person each time. And if you're using the same person, you can't really guarantee that they are available to you 24/7. Now, obviously, if you don't write the captions yourself, it does require a little bit of planning in advance, especially if you want to have the captions ready at the time of publishing the video. I usually upload my video a day before publishing it on YouTube, and that allows for enough turnaround time for the captions. For my videos that are usually around 8 to 10 minutes, the captions are mostly ready within 4 hours. Your video also doesn't need to be final, it just needs to be in picture lock. So your edits should be done and you're not moving things around anymore. The videos I upload to Ref are usually not color graded and the sound effects are not done yet. So you can still work on the video while the captions are being produced. How does Ref work? The whole experience from uploading your video to Ref and reviewing and downloading your final captions file is so simple and honestly a joy, and I can't recommend it more. But before I show you, make sure you hit the like button down below because it will really help me out with the YouTube algorithm. First, you select the type of text service you need. You can choose between transcription, captions, or foreign subtitling. We are using the caption service, which is $125 per video minute. So for an 8 to 10 minute video, you would usually end up paying about $10 to $12, which is, I think, about 15 Australian, and for me, absolutely worth it. I'm all for efficiency in my side hustle, even if it costs a little bit of money. And what better to spend your 9-to-5 money on than on something that saves you time, right? Once you've uploaded your video, you enter the payment method or choose the safe payment and submit your order. Once you submitted your order, you can add a glossary, which is pretty cool. So if you have any special terms in your video or names of people or products, then you can add them in here and they will be spelled correctly in your captions. Yeah, and then you wait. Shout out to the person who's writing the captions for this video, whoever you are. Thank you. I appreciate you. Leave your name in the captions or a smiley face or something. When your captions file is ready, Ref will email you, and then you can log in and review your captions and make changes if necessary. I'm a huge fan of the Ref editor. It's so, so easy to use. For the most part, the captions are accurate and pretty much published ready. I only ever watch the video once to double check everything and maybe correct one or two words, which I probably didn't pronounce well in the video. Once you finish your review, you can hit download and Ref gives you different format options. I usually use .srt, which is pretty standard. And that's it. Now you can upload your captions file when publishing your video. If you did make more edits to your video and you need to adjust the timing of your captions, you can import the file into Premiere Pro and make changes, but I wouldn't recommend it. Depending on where you made the edit, it can possibly throw off large parts of your video, and then you end up spending all that time adjusting it. And if that then takes you 1 or 2 hours, then you could have just written it yourself. That's it for this video. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope you found it useful. Let me know in the comments below if you have any questions or what method you are using for your captions. Also, make sure you check out last week's video where I talk about how I link my YouTube videos on social media to turn my followers into subscribers. Next week's video will be a little bit different. I'm going to tell you how I ended up moving to Australia 4 years ago. So if you don't want to miss that, make sure you subscribe, and I'll see you next week. Take care. Take care? Take care? What is this? What is this? Am I going into a little dance routine? I mean, I could. I used to dance when I was a kid. So I'm... Nah, not gonna do that. Not gonna do that. Thank you.